singles because we're just a little bit
behind. We need to set up a couple more of these TVs because we have plenty of TVs and plenty of setups. Like, we have 9 setups for 23 people. It's like better than most Melee tournaments around here.
Yeah, so we got the pools ready to go after this is over. We'll have the guys in Grand Finals play towards the end so they get a little bit of a break.
Are you kidding me? What kind of pool is that? It's a terribly hard pool.
You should see the other ones.
Oh my god. We just have a lot of great players out here
today. Tilts for days right now, both Kirby's.
So you're going to see throughout this entire match, D-Tan being a very grounded Kirby, he's really going to try and get above red
good
team.
Back there. That's the D-Tan special off the edge, as long as he does that. Ooh, beautiful forward smash from DeBear. And that is one thing that's always interesting for me from DeBear and God is that they're definitely the more aggressive team. But you'll see a lot of instances where if it's a 1v2, most people are going to back out.
Right.
DeBear or God are just going to go in. They're just going to go for it and see if they can either trade or at least get damage down while their teammate is reviving. Ooh. DeBear goes for a spike just a little bit off.
All right, D-Tan makes it on stage, but he's in a really rough spot right now. He makes it out of that.
I'm liking D-Tan's defensive play right now. He's getting out of a lot of situations where he's sandwiched just by throwing those down airs and letting Dog get back into shape for him. And their reads off each other are pretty great. It's nice to see that in doubles.
Which team are you talking about?
D-Tan and Dog. Both of them, to be fair. But the amount of times that someone
I was saying last match that you could really just describe their team one way. Good pickup.
Solid dash
also, DeBear was just commentating, and he was saying that in doubles, he loves just going in. Like, you see a lot of people camping around. He loves just going in and getting a hit because something's going to happen. And he likes that little bit of chaos.
He likes to be the instigator, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Well, another interesting thing, I was just playing some singles with God before that. Apparently, other than just like yesterday, he hasn't played much since August.
Since August. Yeah, he looks terrible today. Yeah, sure.
And here he
is right now
in Grand Finals. So he's crushing right now. He's also a Falcon Man.
Well, he plays a little more Pika these days.
Ooh, great down tilt from D-Tan. Secures the last stock there. And they're going to see if they can close out here on God.
And blue team now with a little bit of a lead. They were down a little bit.
We'll have to see if this goes the same way as always. One team always goes up 2-0 in this set.
You think so?
They always go 2-0, and the other team makes it back. Ooh. Short hop Nair to finish that one out.
Oh, what are you doing? D-Tan just standing there, gets Nair, dies for it.
This is going to be rough for God, though. Already in a combo. Oh, the brothers combos. Makes his way back. They got plenty of room to work with right now. This is a real uphill
climb. They love
their
team combos. I feel like they actually just will go for the team combo. Over something easy or over like, oh, we could just spike them right now. But that
great
wouldn't
coverage.
Be a team combo, right?
It wouldn't be the brother's way of doing it.
It wouldn't be the brother's way of doing it. All right, that's game 1 of 10. We only got 9 more to go.
They just admit to playing somehow a best of 10, which doesn't really exist.
Now that we've properly taunted, proper neutral start.
Right.
Something I really like about all their matches, every match starts with everybody just hitting each other. There's not a clear advantage. There's not a, you know, everybody, like, one team lost three stocks or something like that. It is everybody's hitting each other, and now red team's in the league. That's how it happened. There wasn't these team combos or positioning or something like that.
That sounded so much just like a John Madden comment for the second.
John Madden?
When he puts his contacts in, he can just see better. You know, in Smash, they're going to hit each other.
It's a real physical game.
This is one thing, though, that Dog is really, really good about in this. Just doubles in general. He's totally okay to just sit there for a little bit and just let the game happen before he makes a move.
Oh, he loves sitting there.
A lot of people, including myself, always feel the need to, like, be doing something. Mm-hmm. And ends up getting you into a bad spot almost half the time, I'd say. He's really good about just waiting if D-Tan's got them both, and then he'll just wait for someone to roll out, and he'll hit him with a punish out of the tech.
Which is a lot of confidence in your teammate to say that, well, yeah, he could totally handle both players right now. There's no need for me to go in and down air or something like that.
Yeah.
And break this up.
It's just really smart reserve play.
That's something that I noticed about the Wake Brothers is that if their teammate's in trouble, there's a lot of times in doubles where you'll just go in and attack the whole pile of people and then hope that something good comes out of it. They rarely do that. They rarely just go in and try and disrupt things.
Now, this is interesting. This has been mentioned a little bit before. But with DeBear and God, in most situations, it's usually DeBear that's the one going in. And recently, with him playing Kirby in doubles instead of Pika, he's been being a little bit more of the defensive stock tank type player. He'll make punishes, but
I think we made this comment earlier. Yeah. But God has one mode, and that's attack. DeBear at least has the ability to hang back in camp. Like, he's aware that it's a good strategy, and he knows when he wants to implement. He's very conscious of it.
Whereas, ooh, almost.
God is just not the kind of person to hang back and just let things happen, which can kind of be said by his character choices, because he plays Pika and Falcon. He plays Falcon in singles. That's the most aggressive character you can play. He plays Pika in teams. It's also a very aggressive player.
DeBear played that really well after that grab for the kill. He ended up positioning over the edge as God was recovering, too, to make sure that D-Tan couldn't go out for a spike on him or even threaten. So he positioned himself to cover even after the kill, which was really nice. It's good stuff. And breaks combo offer on his teammate.
He's playing some excellent support right now.
We'll have to see that.
He hung on
to
that stock for a minute.
Ooh.
So, in this matchup, D-Tan's most likely the aggressor, just because he's the better player of the two of them. That's how it's gone.
Okay.
That's just how it's gone, and that D-Tan's normally the aggressor in these situations, and that Dog will play support. What I noticed when, because we've seen this matchup all day, of course, what I've noticed is that when there's a double Pika team, the Wake Brothers have a difficult time deciding who's going to be the aggressor.
Sure.
Because it's really hard for Kirby to go against two Pikachus. It's hard for D-Tan to be that aggressor.
Not really. I'm not sure what D-Tan was doing there. He was just kind of throwing moves in the corner, and it definitely cost him a stock.
And now Red Team has a big lead.
Yeah, but those are... With Pikachu going down, this game's a lot closer than it looks. Kirby... Ooh.
Ooh. That's a lot closer than it looks.
Oh, rip. It hurts. Hurts bad.
Well, now this is anybody's game again.
What I was going to say is Kirby's at kill percent, but when you press start, it doesn't matter. Now it's just a one stock.
If he had a downer, D-10, that would have killed.
D-10.
Oh, he missed the ledge.
And this looks like a solid setup for game one. Ooh, great recovery from Dog. Wow. Dog is going deep.
Wow.
Dude, he is out for blood. Oh.
Is he going to get that one?
Oh, my gosh.
Can he recover against the bear? Oh, and he gets that grab out of the down air.
Oh.
Good tech. That's going to be
it?
No
way.
Oh, my God.
Dog clutches out. Oh, whew. What a play. He went so deep off the edge.
Just think of all the events that had to lead to that in the last minute alone.
How deep is deep?
How deep is deep? He really clutched that out. And something I noted to D-Tan, because he asked me what they did wrong during their winter set. And I said, nothing really. They just clutched you out at the end. Every time that they won a game, they just clutched a little harder than you guys. And that time, Dog clutched a lot harder.
That was impressive, man.
After the two stock loss due to that pause.
Yeah, I was just going to say, man, you got to wonder now, because they're going right into these games. You got to wonder if that affects mentality at all in this game, especially with it being 2-0 already. Mm-hmm. Is that pause going to be something that they actually have to take all the way until a reset to kind of get their mentality back? We'll have to wait and see, but D-10 and Dog are looking really solid now.
I love that D-Tan does that. Anytime he gets a grab on a character, he'll wait for the other teammate to try and come save him, and then he'll do a forward throw, and he'll get out of the way immediately.
He doesn't do the forward throw
and like before the character gets there, because then they have a chance to punish after Kirby does his little backflip animation.
And you see they're so patient, and both teams have the same setup here with the Kirby covering top, trying to get advantage on the top platform, with the Pikachu covering underneath.
And generally, I've seen DeBear win the aerial battle, but they don't hit each other.
True.
Because D-Tan immediately bails, knowing that I'm not higher than him. I can't get to him.
Yeah.
So he has to retreat. And that also kind of highlights the complete opposite play styles of like the aggressive red team and the defensive blue team.
I gotta say,
oh my god, look at this! And that's gonna be two stocks right there.
I know there's still been a lot of Pika Kirby.
Yeah.
But for only having 11 teams, we had a lot of character diversity. We had Luigi.
I think we did. We had
Fox, Ness, Donkey Kong,
Samus.
We had Samus for a little bit. Was that Mad Rush?
Yeah. There was another team.
That's not
what
bad.
What was the? Lucanus and Hipster.
They played Donkey Kong Kirby.
They played Donkey Kong Samus at one point.
Did they really?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Or was it Ness?
This is looking rough right now, man, for DeBear and God.
I'm pretty sure there was a Samus and Ness team at one point.
Really?
Anyways, yeah, there was a good amount of character diversity in the early rounds.
Ooh.
D-Tan fights his way back on stage.
He's in a tough spot right now. Nice coverage by Dog. Nice.
He's
job,
so good though. At waiting it out, like maximizing his time off stage to make sure that his brother could come help him.
Absolutely.
And it really pays off, because look at this. He's still hanging on to that sock. They got rid of God's sock.
God's on his last stock. Oh, that could be it. Almost. This sets him up. Ooh, good recovery. Goes high.
This is looking like a smart solid call. 3-0 reset, which we can't have. Something's got to happen. We can't have not 15 games.
I think the rest of the people here would appreciate it.
I think a lot of people. I know Boom would appreciate it. Well, he's not watching. He bugged out when it was all peak Kirby like an hour ago.
So, I know he said Dog was clutch in the 2v1, but now we have to see God come back from a 7-stock deficit. And it's not going to happen. So we get the bracket reset.
We got the reset.
That was
a fast reset.
That was the fastest reset these guys have ever played. This is it.
And just more games. Here we go.
When Kirby's trying to camp that top platform, you'll see those Pikas try and shark that up air underneath it consistently to get
really
the tail.
Really like that recovery by D-Tan. He's been working on that, just getting to the ledge, rather than doing an up B to the ledge. Like, because a lot of the time when you're Kirby and you're lower, you feel like, oh, I have to up B at this point and try and hit them or something like that. A lot of the time, players will just be covering that exact option. You could just jump straight to ledge if you want. Like I said, the match
waiting
just begins
out
with everybody hitting each other.
Good wait by DeBear, though. Keeps himself alive, waits for God to get back, and keeps it a one-stock game. Good neutral air from D-Tan, though.
He likes doing that on recovery. He has a lot of different recovery mix-ups.
He does.
And different moves that he throws out. Forward air, he'll use a lot of the time and catch people and do a reverse edge guard on them. Or Nair's, also pretty good. He'll use that a lot.
D10 had some good shield pressure going there.
See,
but,
right there.
Got it and broke it up.
Went straight to ledge. Good option.
D10 and Dog, though, have had pretty solid advantage in holding stage control.
I think they value it more. Like, mm-hmm. they personally feel like it's important to always have stage control, and it's always in the back of their mind.
It is. All right, it definitely is.
It is, but I'm not saying that's wrong. I'm saying that they value it a lot more than DeBaron and God do.
Yeah, true.
DeBaron and God are not as concerned with stage presence.
Absolutely. But I think that's part of what's costing them right now is if you notice the amount of time that DeBaron and God both have been on the stage at the same time is not very much.
It's not very much.
They're usually
especially like on the ground together. They're just not there.
And so they're great players and they're getting a lot of opportunistic kills.
Oh man, Dog upbees off stage. Good stock cancel.
Ooh, good back air. And so once again, they're going to set up, with recovery from God. Sets up the Wake Bros with a one stock lead right now.
D10 wasn't in position for that.
Not yet.
Normally he's almost always ready for those.
Oh, D10's in an interesting spot, but Dog comes in, saves him out. Ooh, nice wait by Dog. Stops the hit so that when he gets the back throw, he keeps the hit and keeps throwing. And a beautiful down tilt into back air. D10 just covering both sides. Dog's happy to sit and watch.
Yeah,
that.
Dog's happy to sit and watch that. Yeah, he's not trying to pick. He doesn't have like a sense of pride. Like, oh man, my brothers get. I gotta get some kills
great.
Right now. Like,
oh man, D10 is taking care of this right now. Nice combo. Oh, great damage. And that puts Kirby in kill percent. That'll put DeBaron, his last stock, in kill percent. He's got to play safe. Ooh.
And a shield break. Oh, boy. This is going
to
be
This
bad.
Looks to be...
Oh. This is a true combo. Does he get it? Oh! That's got to be so hard in doubles just because there's like a slight amount of lag. We have an overclock console, but that's such a tight timing to get.
Once again, it's down to God in the battle. Battle against fate, five stocks. Now, with this being four games in a row, do you see a potential change
yes.
from DeBaron?
Yeah.
Do you think you're going to see Pika Pika?
I think I'm going to see the Pika Pika.
I just think, for anything, they're going into games really quick right now. Like, they're losing the game by four or five stocks even, and immediately starting the next one.
That's the kind of wavelength that they operate on. They're on.
That's a difference between them. But you'll see D10 and Orion in between. Sorry, D10 and Dog.
They'll be talking about it in between.
Yeah,
even
in between
on,
games.
Yeah.
Four
even
in a
games
row.
That they win, they're going to be talking about it right now. See, look at them. They're just like conversing. What are we going to do? Yep. See, Pika Pika.
Yep. You know, it is funny to see this though because. Previously, in both of the times that it's been this matchup, DeBaron God versus D10 and Dog in finals, the last two times it's happened, it's been a lot of DeBaron like shouting out plays at God. And this time, I'm not hearing as much talking. I'm seeing God with a big smile on his face most of the time though, but DeBaron's pretty quiet. Which
I think DeBaron's feeling the pressure a little bit now. He was having a really good time when they won their winner's set.
Yeah.
And now the gears are turning a little bit. What can we do that's a little better? I think God is just happy to be playing again because he hasn't been playing that much.
God close on landing the thunder, but just a little bit off. Those kills are really critical when you get a light character up on top of the stage. To close something out at 60 is pretty big.
A little miscommunication from Blue there. Something to see from them.
Nice top platform will kill on Pika with that. Oh, close. They almost had all the
options.
D10
gets an annoying amount of... I don't think there's a single Kirby that gets more kills than him with forward throw. Maybe Revan?
I mean, off top plat, that's pretty straightforward. But yeah, he does get a lot.
He just does it a lot, is what
good
I noticed.
Play.
He just wins out neutral and then eventually throws them. That's a little more commentary on his singles play, though.
You know, it's funny. I feel after winners finals when D-Tan and Duck had lost. Mm-hmm. Saw D-Tan kind of over in the corner. Like, oh, I was watching some like million dollar baby type deal. He was like hyping himself up, getting focused, getting back, and now he's like gone through his hyperbolic time chamber and reached his level again to play. Because he's looking
the,
pretty
the Wake
solid.
Brothers get really downtrodden when they lose. Like, they are a little struck, and they gotta take a minute. They gotta take a breather.
However, gotta point out to DeBear and God, this is a really good setup for this game so far.
Right. I think it's a good switch for them. And as I said before, it's really hard for, like, you saw these last couple games. Mm-hmm. D-Tan's getting like the last five stocks. He's closing all of them out himself.
Side note, D-Tan has called out God's Edge Zip Zap like four times with down tilt. Like, he is reading him right now, which is a frustrating feeling when you feel like someone just knows what you're going to do a second before. Mm-hmm. It's like the fourth time in this Grand Finals. But I don't even know, other than maybe game one, if DeBear and God have had a lead for more than 30 seconds in this game, in this whole
game
series.
Game two of the first set, that was the incredibly close one where they were actually up by two stocks.
Mm-hmm.
And then God accidentally
Dog
paused.
Brought it back, you're right.
Yeah.
That was a clutch game. That was a big turning point.
Like, as I was saying, like, D-Tan is able to get a lot of these kills himself. And you see, like, you can see how well
nice
he's
edging. Nice DI, though.
Red team is still has the lead. I mean, they're in a bad position right now, but stock-wise, they do have the lead. Oh,
rough.
Not anymore.
That'll happen when you don't play since August.
Yeah, it's a lot harder for D-Tan to go in against the Pikachus. He can get these edge guards.
That was a great setup there. But... God.
See, and once again, they're in the lead. They have a, what is that, a one-stock lead? Two-stock lead.
And God did the correct recovery there. When you get drilled at an early percent, you don't want to go straight back up again with the up B. You want to go out first and then over to avoid the second Kirby spike. A smart heads-up play by him. It's easy to get flustered in situations like that in Grand Finals. DeBear is stock tanking like a champ right now, though. We'll see if he can hold on, though. This game's a little closer than it looks with DeBear having four stocks.
Oh, he was trying to up B to the ledge. He missed it. Dog comes in, saves D-Tan. Even though DeBear did cover that second recovery by D-Tan with the up tilt.
I got someone in chat asking, best team in USA. Not sure about that, but they're looking pretty solid.
That's a good question, because they lost at, what, I think it was SmashCon, they lost to Team Love, which is Canada and Mexico, and they lost to Boom and Jamie HR.
Jaime?
Jaime HR, which is also Canada and Mexico.
Cheers, Moon Shoes. This game is real tight now, though. Both teams at almost the exact same. Fortunately, that was DeBear's and not God's.
And the other great team in the USA, the
D-Tan
Hirobi
looks
brothers.
For a great trade. Great, great, great spike there by D-Tan. Fast fall back
wow,
air.
What? Like, these stocks just melted away.
Into the down tilt, man.
They were up by two stocks, and then D-Tan and Dog end up winning by three there.
I need a down tilt counter on stream.
A down tilt counter?
One, two, three. That was like the seventh one that he's called somebody out on that and just sniped them right when they're trying to go for a ledge grab. Man. All right. They're taking some time.
They've taken five straight games. I feel like God and Bear need to give themselves a
Kiro
second.
And Stranded aren't that good. Oh, chat.
That's just Shears for you.
I don't know if they've played more than once. I think Kiro and Stranded, I think, only played them once.
Like
D-Tan
and
Dog.
Yeah, they only played
them
once. Yeah, they won. Mm-hmm. Actually, I'm wondering if they played two sets. I'd have to go back and look through the bracket.
I don't remember.
I'd have to ask somebody.
Once again, just a clown fiesta of a start here. Everyone go. Kirby's throw up tilts. Pika's throw neutral airs or up airs.
Oh. All right. Messed up B right there, but...
Now, can they close out on the D? That's good. That's a good trade for them.
Yeah, D10 and Dog double eliminated them at boss battle.
Any time that you have a stock lead on the Kirby, it's super helpful because it kind of minimizes his ability to go out and take that risk for a trade of kills. Especially with double Pika, because both of them can go out and challenge.
I can't believe he got out of
that.
Wow. How the hell did he get out of that with two Pikachu?
The clutch jab.
And he forward smashes them both. Oh my god.
D-Chan just jabs him in the face and
says
no.
Jabs him in the face. Yeah, was that the best option? I guess so.
It was for him. Oh. Both Pikas in the up tilt. They're in his wheelhouse, man. Another.
Okay, I think they're. I gotta highlight a problem that DeBaron got her having is that they are trying to fight D-Tan, and you shouldn't fight D-Tan. Dog is standing there and just letting them.
Well, and I mean this is a classic thing for God. We've already highlighted that he's an aggressive player.
Yeah.
And especially when you've lost 5 games in a row, you get really headstrong about like, no, I can do this. No, I can make the same thing happen. So he's running in a lot.
That was a really good sequence by them. Mm-hmm. And that's, here they're able to take 2 stocks right there. They're actually in the lead.
There you go.
They got a little percent on.
This is the same spot that they were in last game about this time. So let's see if they can hold on now.
All right, see if the bear can wait out that invincibility.
If that hit side plat, I think that might have killed. I don't remember the percents exactly.
I heard Dark Horse say the percents at one point, but then during Genesis 4, the exact numbers did happen to come up from some forward throws.
Great
and it didn't kill.
Spikes.
Look at this, they're 2 stocks ahead now.
Mm-hmm. They can turn a game so quick.
Red team had a lead.
Well, and you'll notice too, a lot of these fights, you'll see D-Tan and Dog moving in cohesion with each other instead of separating. And you're seeing a lot of, if I were to put the players from left to right, you'll see a red Pika, then both of the blue team, then the other Pika on the other side.
Right.
So there's no coordinated time for it.
I think their biggest problem, and I noticed this in a lot of teams, and even when we teamed, when you're together, you just decide, okay, you individually decided, oh, we're going to just jump right now and throw out a move, and then you end up hitting each other.
That was a cheeky try there by D-Tan.
You got to go for it.
Mm-hmm. Well, especially when you're up 2 games in reset grand finals.
But D-Tan and Dog are really good at moving together. That's something that you just have to have played with a person for a while and understand their habits and where they're going to go.
You know, it's almost like they're brothers.
Almost. They're more like cousins, really.
I need a DNA test for that, but it's almost like they're brothers. Nice job for the Pikas to stay above D-Tan there, though. That was good. They both went together.
This is looking really grim for Red Team. That's going to be a stock right there, yeah. And can DeBear clutch out 4 stocks against the Wake Brothers? Oh! Hit that swag button.
And that's it, guys. D-Tan Dog straight 3-0 into a 3-0 after the bracket reset.
That's the fastest grand finals that those teams have ever played.
Wow.